imagine that you're feeling very, very sick, like something is very wrong with you. So you go to the hospital and they run a series of tests, which scares you even more, and then you hear the scariest thing of your life. You have kidney disease, and without a transplant, you will die in months. This is a reality for so many people in America. Kidney disease is just one of the many diseases and traumatic experiences that could cause you to die without a transplant. There are tens of thousands of people on the transplant list, and if everyone in America donated their organs after they died, the transplant list would be far shorter. I plan to discuss today the dire need for more organ donors, how to become an organ donor, and a possible program that could shorten the transplant list dramatically. No one deserves to live a life confined to being sheltered, having to be careful all the time, and having to worry if they are going to run out of time. There are over 120,000 Americans on the transplant list. Another name is added to this list every 10 minutes. And on average, 22 people die a day waiting for a transplant. This is 8,000 people a year, according to the American Transplant Foundation. Many are unaware of the difference that they can make if they donate their organs after they die. You can save up to 8 people with just your internal organs. 95% of Americans that were polled said that they are in favor of donating organs. However, only 35% of those people, 52% of those people are registered donors. This could be simply because they are unaware of how to become a donor, or because they are undereducated about what organ donation is, so they can't form their opinion on it. Almost anyone can become a donor, no matter your age, race, or sexuality. All people age 18 and older can register to be an organ, eye, or tissue donor. You can choose what you wish to donate, and you can change your status at any point in time, says Donate Life America. This is a program that is not connected to donation completely, but they promote it. Religiously, some people do not agree with organ donation because they feel their body should be buried whole. However, many religions do support organ donation and saving lives in general. Many religions have come out to the public and made a statement saying that people of that religion can donate their organs without worrying about heaven or hell. I'd like to give you a quote from the Huffington Post. Many people avoid becoming organ donors as they are afraid it will affect their own medical treatment. For example, they believe that doctors and surgeons might not try to the best of their ability to save them when they find out that they are organ donors. However, this again is a fallacy, and the surgeons involved in saving their lives are completely different from the ones that do the organ donations. To them, no one life is more important than another, and they're going to be focused on saving the person in front of them. You can make a difference. We all can. 81% of you in this class told me in a poll that you on your license are organ donors. Only 19% of you are not. This is a 17-to-4 ratio, which tells me that most of you are willing to stand behind me in making a movement to create more donors in America. If the government would start a program to make organ donation compulsory, then everyone would be considered a donor unless they opted out. To opt out, there would be no questions asked. All you would have to do is go to your local BMV like we do now and tell them you would not like to be a donor. As all of you know, our state has a program to where when you get your license or permit, you are asked if you'd like to be a donor or not. However, in many states, they do not do this program, and they have to get online and register to be a donor, which takes much more effort, and many people are too lazy or they don't feel like doing it. So if everyone switched to our state's program, we would have far more organ donors because they would not have to put in nearly enough as much effort. all we can do is spread awareness. Because many people probably won't agree with the compulsory organ donation program. However, I think it would be the best choice for our nation. Many states will not switch to our program that we have in Indiana, so that it won't be as easy for people to donate. So all we need to do is get in the schools, hospitals, and on TV and tell everyone that they need to be a donor, save lives, and make a difference. It is said that if a dead man still lives, that the effects of his life are still being felt. So all of you registered, be donors today.
Do you know like what religions like don't like people donating?
I believe Buddhists do not like donation. Because they have like a strict like whole body burial type of thing.
What is the state's reasoning for not wanting to like move towards our state's
plan? I could not find any reasoning. I just know that a lot of them just don't have it on their licenses. I guess they just feel like you should have a whole separate like donation card. That's what most of them have, is a donation card. You fill out registration and then they send it to you in the mail.
Do you know how many states actually allow you to be like a donor, like that you put on your license instead of having to go the other
route? I could not find how many states exactly did that, because so many of the states have such diverse ways of doing it. So they might not do it exactly like ours, but they might do a similar program. So it's hard to find an exact number.
Will they take organs from people that like have, you know, autism or Down syndrome?
The organs of someone with autism or Down syndrome are completely viable. They work the same way as yours or mine. The only conditions that would be, like, make your organs not viable are, like, cancer and kidney disease. Like, if you have diseases in your own body, then they can't give those to somebody else.
What about, like, kidney stones? Because you can get them
removed. A lot of times they don't want to take any type of flawed organ, because that increases the risk for an infection. So not only do you have to perform the procedure to transfer the organ, but you also have to do a separate one to remove the stones.
Do you choose which organs you want to donate?
With the registration that many people do, you have to fill out like a thing. You can do internal organs, you can donate your retina, you can give people sight, like, it's amazing. And you can donate your tissue, like, you can donate skin. Like, you can donate anything you want, but you have to, like, go through a system. And if it, for our state, you would have to, like, put it in your will or make sure it's known to your family.
All right, we're going to have to move on. Sorry.
It's